Hey everybody, welcome back to Golf Test Dummy and another episode of Sundays at 3 with GTD. Let's get right into it. Alright, like I said, today we're just going to jump into this video. I've got a topic that I want to talk about with you guys. We're talking about walking versus riding. Now, instantly, I know that all of you are going to have sort of a reaction to this. You're on one side of the fence or the other. And down in the comments below, I know you guys are going to have lots of things to say, either for or against, or maybe some of you are kind of indifferent. Maybe you use a combination of walking and riding. But down in the comments below, feel free to leave your thoughts for me and for other people and to start sort of a conversation going on where we can go back and forth. I just wanted to kind of share a little bit of background for some context here to get us going. I know that golf carts, you know, they came out, I think, in about the 30s is when they were introduced. They really got popular around the late 50s, early 60s. That's when they kind of really started to take hold. And it seems that there's kind of a cultural divide between the United States and other countries. And I'm not saying that the United States is alone in their heavy cart usage, and that everybody else in the entire planet other than the United States is not using carts at all. I don't want to present it in that way, but culturally speaking, it seems to me like the U.S. is very heavily pro-golf cart. I don't have a problem with golf carts at all. I don't want this to come off in that way, but more and more I'm trending toward walking more often. Suffice it to say, I believe there is a little bit of a cultural difference. I think a lot of countries over in the U.K. and just overseas in general, they tend to walk more. The carts seem to be more reserved for people who have sort of some disabilities, or they just aren't as mobile, or they just don't have the stamina. Whereas, you know, in the U.S., it doesn't matter who you are, what age you are. It seems almost exclusive that we are riding carts over here. I think only about maybe 4 or 5%, from one of the statistics that I read, only about 4 or 5% of the people in the U.S. are going without a cart, and they're either carrying their own bag or they're using a push cart, a pull cart, or even a motorized push cart. So I'm not exactly sure how that cultural divide came to be. It's probably a combination of things. It may have something to do with the traditional golf model and people who are more purists, who look back on the history of the game when it started back in Scotland like 500-600 years ago, and how it survived for so many hundreds of years in its current state. And relatively speaking, the riding cart in golf is a fairly new piece of the puzzle. It's a fairly new piece of tech if you consider that the golf cart has been around for a good bit less than 100 years, and it's only been popular in, say, the last 60 to 70. And then you look at the age of golf as a whole, you're talking several hundred years as opposed to 60, 70 years. The biggest benefit that usually gets thrown out there to walking is the health benefits. You get the exercise. Anywhere between, I would say, 3 and 6 miles, sometimes even more, walking is involved when you are carrying your bag or using a push cart as opposed to riding in a golf cart. But you are getting in a lot of walking, and for people out there who use fitness trackers, you can easily get your 10,000 steps in walking and using a push cart or carrying your own bag. So another thing that people quite often throw out as a pro for walking is the mental side of the game, meaning that when you're in a cart, a lot of times you're just zooming from your shot to your next shot, and you don't really have time to digest the previous shot. It could have been a bad shot that you're trying to get out of your head, or maybe it's just a pace thing. Maybe you just feel like you're being rushed and you need to slow down a little bit. So there are certainly people who make the case that walking and playing golf as opposed to riding is better for your mental game. And that kind of goes into the next one, where people talk about timing. And timing in a sense of how you're playing, but also timing in a sense of how long it takes you to play golf. A lot of people would say that, you know, riding in a cart is much faster than people who walk. And I'll get into that here in a second. Now, the case for riding in a golf cart, the number one thing that most people would say is the benefit is that they're tired from their week of work, and they want to get out and they want to enjoy their round, and they don't have to work as hard. It's just convenient. It's relaxing. It's more like a spa day where you're going out and it's like, golf's hard enough. I don't need to make it any more difficult. It's convenient to get into this cart, and I'm just going out to play with the guys. And, you know, it's just a fun thing to do. Actually, riding in a golf cart and touring around as you look at the scenery going from shot to shot, a lot of times can be a nice way to view the golf course. It's almost like, you know, an Uber. Another benefit could be the social aspect of it. You're paired up with somebody in a cart, so you're riding with a partner that day. You know, maybe you're riding with your favorite person to play golf with. Maybe you're riding with somebody who you just met and you get to know that person. You kind of feel that buddy system out there, so you don't feel like you're alone. Obviously, if you have some sort of a disability or a mobility issue or, you know, something that prevents you from being able to walk an entire golf course, obviously riding in a cart is going to be, you know, the way to go for you. It's not a choice that you make. It's almost a necessity for you to be able to play golf. If you have some sort of an ailment or a disability, you pretty much need a golf cart. Now, if you're talking about the course itself, the course health itself, most people would make the debate that walking with a push cart or carrying your bag as opposed to riding in a machine, a golf cart on the course that is either going to be gas or electric, it's going to have much more benefit to the course itself, because a lot of people, when they go out and they're riding along, if the course is wet and they haven't put out signs to say 90 degrees only or cart path only, people are just riding with heavier carts with two people and two bags and the weight of the cart itself. They're just traveling all over the golf course and they're making tracks potentially. They're tearing things up. A lot of people abuse the carts. You know, people who just don't care about the course itself, and they tear things up. They tend to cause a little bit of havoc and be sort of a nuisance to the course itself. And certainly, you know, when you're walking or using a push cart, you're much lighter and you're not going to be doing donuts in a push cart because you're just walking along. One thing I do want to talk about is the cost, and it's no contest here who the winner is. Walking is definitely going to save you money. I would say that on average, the cart fees range between $12 and $20, give or take, for the average course. So obviously, you're going to save a ton of money. If you play, let's say, 25 rounds in a year, which is once every 2 months, right? If you play 25 rounds in a year and you save $15 each time, I think that's about $400. That would more than cover the cost of a good push cart, even some of the more upper end push carts that cost you like $250, you would pay for that well inside of a one golf season, and that push cart could last you for years to come. So the cost benefits, it's a no-brainer. Walking definitely saves you money. Now let's talk a little bit about time. How much time does it take to ride versus how much time does it take to walk? I looked this up online because obviously I think I know what their answer is going to be, but I may have sort of a little bit of an issue with the timing that I found online. Now, it says that the average round of golf when you walk takes about 5 hours, whereas in a cart where you're riding, it takes about 3.5 to 4 hours. Now, this to me is definitely a point of contention. I have an issue with this information that I found online, and it just goes to show that context and elaboration is everything. And especially in this situation here, that doesn't necessarily come down to as if you were to put one person pushing a push cart and one person riding in a golf cart, you started them at the same time and you let them play their 18 holes and you put a stopwatch on it. If you're doing that and they're unhindered by people in front of them, you're probably going to see that the time really is not going to vary nearly as much as you think it is. But when you put it into context and you're talking about a busy Saturday or a busy Sunday and you're in traffic and you're waiting on tee boxes, if everybody on the course was walking versus everybody on the course riding, which rounds on average for those people would take less time or more time? That could be up for debate, and a lot of that's going to depend on a lot of factors. It's hard to quantify exactly how that would turn out unless you know a lot of the parameters involved. How much space is in between each hole, you know, from this green to the next tee box? How much distance is there? Is the course really hilly? Who are the people that are walking and who are the people that are riding? How long is the course itself? How good are the players that are playing those rounds of golf? Are they low handicappers, mid handicappers, high handicappers? You can really just play around with all of those figures and numbers and plug in different ones and you'll get a myriad of different results. So it's hard to quantify that. We won't get into that. But I will say this. If you take an average foursome and you put them on an average golf course and there's average distances between holes and you start them out and you put a stopwatch on them and you leave them unhindered by the groups in front of them. They're able to go at their own pace. That's important to establish. They're able to go at their own pace. I think the times would be fairly similar. I think that you could even make the debate that walking would be quicker, because think about it, four people tee off on a tee box. Now, these two are going to get into this cart. These two are going to get into this cart. They're going to take off. Now, the people in this cart, one hit one to the left side of the fairway, one hit one to the right side of the fairway. The people in this cart, one hit one kind of short, one hit one kind of long. So now they have to take off, and this cart has to stop at this ball first, and then you can't advance past this line of people coming up next because you don't want to be out in front of their shot, so you have to wait on them to hit a shot. And now you're going up to the next ball, and each cart has to do that. You have to travel to each ball with that one cart for every shot. Whereas if you're walking, each person tees off, and then each person walks to their own shot and stands there and waits for the person behind, obviously, to hit. But they can be getting ready at their golf ball, making their practice swings, choosing their clubs, getting their yardages, get their mind right, and be ready to hit their shot. You can play more ready golf. I believe that is probably the biggest pro when you're talking about golf as a whole, is to be able to play ready golf. And there are definitely ways to play ready golf out of a golf cart. I'm not saying that. However, I feel like a lot of people that are in carts, in general, generally speaking, are not playing as ready golf as people who are walking. Now, here's something else to consider. And this is a big if. If they were to eliminate golf carts here in the United States and only allow golf carts for those that had, say, a doctor's note or that had a disability or had a condition or an ailment at that time or something that was chronic, if they were able to suddenly eliminate golf carts overnight here in the United States, how crowded do you think courses would be on Saturday and Sunday if everybody had to carry or use a push cart for their rounds? I'm here to tell you, the golf industry in the U.S. would take a serious nose dive. If you told all these golfers in this country that all of a sudden they could not use a golf cart and they had to walk the course, you would see the tee sheets at your local course just empty out. You'd be able to get a tee time almost any day of the week, even on the weekends prime time, with no issue whatsoever. Now, there certainly would be a certain percentage, and let's just say that stat is right, that only 5% of the people in the United States actually walk golf courses. You would certainly see that number grow. You would see people who are like, well, I'm going to play golf. The fact that I can't use a cart, that's okay. It's not a big deal. You might see a jump to where, you know, maybe now 30% or 25% of the golfing population here in the States would be walking. They want to play golf no matter what. They just ride a cart because it's convenient. There's nothing stopping them from riding a cart. And they're like, hey, that's okay with me. It's fine. I'll walk. There would be a large number of golfers that would just stop playing golf altogether. They just wouldn't play anymore. And I wonder what would happen if the inverse happened and said, hey, everybody needs to be riding in a golf cart unless you have some sort of a doctor's note. Would the percentage of people playing go down? Would you see a lot of golfers overseas just have this mass exodus to where they were like, oh, I've got to ride in a cart now? No, I'm done. I'm out. I don't want any part of that. If I can't walk, I'm not playing golf. I don't know. I think they would still play golf. I think they would just gripe about it. I think they would not like it. But I think they would still play golf. But over here, like I said, if you took carts away and you had to walk, you would just see this huge drop in golf participation as a whole across the board. Now, one last thing I do want to mention in this sort of going back and forth that I just feel is it's such a huge factor, okay? Old courses versus new courses. Obviously, overseas, they have courses that are much older than courses here. And older courses tend to be less elaborate. They tend to be less for show. And what I mean by that is that since the 90s and the big boom, when golf made this huge boom, and largely in part due to Tiger Woods, they started to build more and more golf courses. They found that the game was becoming much more and more popular, and so they started to build. There was a building boom. They started to build more and more golf courses. And when they did that, they knew over here that carts were going to be in play, so they had much less consideration for the distance between this green and the next tee box, the distance between holes, that dead space. They were completely fine with having large swaths of dead space because they were using a cart. You know, they're riding in a cart. They know that they're going to go up, and it doesn't matter how much distance is between the holes because you're taking a cart. You don't have to walk that distance. But older courses that were more traditionalist or before golf carts had their big boom, they had to consider how much distance was between holes because you have to walk that distance. And it's tough enough just to walk the holes from tee to green 18 times. But now if you're talking about that dead space in between, you're really talking about all this excess walking that's going to tire you out and has nothing to do with the golf course itself. Not to mention the fact that a lot of these newer courses are dealing with these severe elevation changes. They have to, as time has marched on, they've given less and less consideration to how difficult it is to walk a course because they say, well, they don't have to walk the course, they're going to be riding it. And this golf cart will go up and down hills no problem all day. It's not a concern. We don't even have to think about that part of the equation. And in fact, if you're touring around in a golf cart, the more picturesque it can become, the more amazing it can look, and the more distance between holes, it's actually kind of a draw to that golf course. It actually brings more people in. They say, oh, this course is beautiful. The vistas, the rides through the trees, getting to the next hole, you know, it looks more beautiful. It's actually part of the allure. And so these courses lend themselves to people who want to ride. And I think that pushes us further and further away from being able to walk a course, because whereas, let's just say, a course built in the 1930s, before carts had their big boom, they're going to be a lot more walker-friendly, and therefore they're going to promote more walking, or they're at least going to allow for more walkers. So for me personally, I enjoy walking. I use a push cart. I've recently got a new one. I've got a video coming soon of my review of this push cart. I love it, absolutely. It gives me much more ability to film better on course than if I'm in a cart. There's only so many places that riding carts can go. And if they have declared a 90 degree rule, a lot of times that will cost you more time, and there's really no point in even having that cart. There's tons of factors involved. I haven't even covered them all in this video, but I'd love for you to leave me some comments down below and give me your thoughts on this, and maybe talk about some of the things that I left out. I appreciate you guys spending your Sunday afternoon with me again. Thanks for all the support. I've got plenty more videos coming. Sundays at 3, Wednesdays at 3. That's my two videos a week. Be sure to leave me some comments down below. Give me a thumbs up if you liked it. Tell me what you think about the walking versus riding debate, and I'll see you next time.